Considering the aggressive bids in the past, what strategy is the largest city gas operator, Gujarat Gas, looking to adopt for the auctions this time around? Well, to answer this and to discuss growth prospects for the company, joining us on the phone line is the Chief Executive Officer, Nitin Patil. Thank you for joining us, Mr. Patil. PNGRB has kick-started the ninth round of city gas auctions. Gujarat Gas has been an aggressive bidder in the earlier round. So what's the strategy this time around?
Good morning. Gujarat Gas has evaluated all the primary evaluation has been completed for all the offered areas. And as we do usually, we are doing in-depth study of certain things and based upon the economics and commercial aspect of it, we'll be doing aggressive bidding in certain areas which has been offered.
Will it be fair to assume that you would be more interested in bidding for areas in Gujarat given your strong presence in the state?
Of course, the first preference will be in the Gujarat because we have got already close to 20,000 kilometer pipeline laid, and it will be natural. It will be natural extension of these 19 districts to remaining areas. So there is no doubt we'll be aggressive in Gujarat. But in addition to Gujarat, there are certain locations we found very lucrative from perspective of investment and making a business sense.
So Gujarat.
What areas would this be, Mr. Patil?
See, we are looking at, we have got certain data accumulated with us. And that tells us the demography of it, the population, the vehicle population, and the industrial aspect of it. And based upon that, there are various parts or states will be bidding very aggressively.
So I think the question that comes, Mr. Patil, is that you've enjoyed particular growth rates now with analytics and other factors that you spoke about. You have advanced information about pockets which could be high growth in nature. What does this mean for how Gujarat Gas's growth trajectory would shape up over the course of the next couple of years?
See, we always conservatively say that we look at about 10 to 15% year-on-year growth. And that will remain our basic strategy and we'll be working towards that all the time.
Okay. Sir, I also believe that you're looking at new geographical areas of Silvassa, rural Ahmedabad and Palghar. Is that correct? And how much will these new areas add to overall volume, say, by 2020?
All the three areas has been licensed to us. And very happy to put on record here that already Dadra Nagar Haveli, we have been connected. Gas is flowing. Couple of industries already connected. One CNG station is already flowing gas. Another two are in pipeline and will be done. Thane, rural and Palghar, again, I will be very happy to put on records that the connectivity has been now available with us. And by this weekend, we will be firing gas in Tarapur itself.
I was hoping to get a sense, Mr. Patil, of what are these high growth areas that you spoke about in the previous answer B? Because you mentioned that while the preference will be Gujarat, there are these other areas. So, do they extend to states far and beyond Gujarat?
Yes, it is indeed.
But what areas would these be, if you can share some names?
I will not quote the names now, right? But there are even Chennai. Everybody would like to say bid for Chennai. It's a very lucrative, if that gives any indication to you, right?
Also shifting focus on Gujarat State Petronet, one of your promoter companies, which will be buying stake, 28.4% stake in your company from Gujarat State Petroleum. So post that, Gujarat State Petronet, of course, will become your holding company. Do you see any sort of synergies coming in from this ownership rejig?
Yeah, you put up the correct word there. It's a synergy. GSPL is a transmission company, whereas Gujarat Gas is fully into distribution of the gas. And both of us together are very complementary to each other, and that gives us a lot of flexibility and agility in delivering our objective business objectives.
So, just what is your reading on how spot or how LNG prices will shape up in 2018? Because any sharp rise in spot LNG prices would be a key risk for you. So, your thoughts on how you expect LNG prices to move?
whatever market indications we have got or the information we have on hand, it just states that the LNG prices will remain at a lower side or middle side for next 4 to 5 years. And I have not seen any drastic change into that, unless other there is certain global things happening which are beyond prediction.
But gas prices are likely to go up, right? There is a hike that is expected as well. So what would you do if LNG prices are going to stay as gas prices will move up? Will you pass on the hike to ahead, or that won't be the case?
See, all the current fuel prices are somehow related to crude. So crude goes up, prices goes up, there is no doubt about it. So our competitive fuel prices will also go up, and we are confident there will be a place we can pass on those prices to the customers.
So you will pass it on, because I believe April is when we will see the hike, right, Mr. Patil?
Domestic gas price will hike, which is maybe one-third of our total consumption, but still they will remain very competitive to the normal LNG prices.
Okay.
Your volume growth in the past has been slightly on the weaker side, mainly because of the decline in the offtake to industries. What is the kind of gas volume growth that we could, or what would be a fair estimate for the kind of growth we could see for FY19?
See, we always stated that our year-on-year growth will be 10%, and last year and this year, if you compare, last year it was 5.2 to 5.4. Now this year it is average about 6.1. So that will remain. We don't see any problem into that.
Okay. So, but as far as your EBITDA per SCM is concerned, that continues to remain lower as compared to some of your other listed peers. What is the thought process and plans to increase the same, or will they remain at the kind of levels that we have seen of late?
Thanks for asking this question, because that actually defines our strategy, how we work. When you lay the pipeline are not laid for the 1 year or 2 years, 3 years time. They are there for 30, 40, 50 years. And when you even buy the LNG, you don't buy the long-term LNG for, say, 1 year or 2 years. It is usually for longer period than that. No doubt our two-third is a long-term, whereas one-third is our spot and other things what we buy. And that requires your business to have a long-term tie-up of your customers, right? So we believe in to have a moderate price and making, say, about 4 to 5 rupees of EBITDA margin per SCM. And that is our strategy, where the customer also understand that company is there for the long haul, not for the, you know, operate, make money and go away.
Yeah, I'm certain that most people would have that view. Mr. Patil, with the kind of business that you are in, maybe the nature of the work as well, but you have to admit that the operational picture does look or does gyrate quite a bit, quarter on quarter, over the quarters as well. And I would reckon that if we look at the last 5 years, then maybe the years as well. What's the steady state operational picture that you forecast or that you believe Gujarat Gas can show or will see over the next 3 or 4 years?
You are absolutely right when you say quarter on quarter the thing changes. Many businesses are cyclical, so in somewhere we are a little bit cyclical in terms of making margins, I can say. The LNG prices do changes a lot, especially in winter they go too high and in summer they come down. And that is where at times we have to squeeze our margin, we do that, and at there is a time we make margin, but we also ensure that annual basis our EBITDA remains in that range of 4 to 5, that what we have stated.
So any sort of indications, you know, if you've already planned for the kind of capex outlay that will be there for FY19?
Madam, we usually have a capital plan deployed as we go on accrual, which is always 500 to 600 crores per annum. That is through our accruals. However, now the Thane has come up, the permissions are now flowing. We expect early resolution to Ahmedabad issue, and Dadra Nagar Haveli has picked up. So if the situation demands, we do not mind preponing or advancing some of our capexes and may go for 700-800 if situation demands.
Right, sir, but how much of that would be spent on building CNG outlets? How much will be on the pipeline infrastructure? If you can give us a sense of how the breakup would be.
Once again, thanks for that question. Last year, we built about 22 CNG stations. This year, inching toward 46. Because last year, we have shared in various platforms with our investors, stating that when I took over two years back, it was about 80% was industrial and 20% was CNG, PNG. And after doing a brainstorming with team, we said that we have to see if we can reach to 60-40, 60% industries and 40% CNG, PNG. Happy to put on record here that currently our about 68% is industries and rest is 32 is CNG, PNG. That clearly indicates what we are trying to do. We are trying to even increase CNG penetration. What we deployed last year was we formed a special team of people and deployed for that. Before that, we did a lot of traffic studies. We identified location spots where make business sense. And if you come across Gujarat, you will find that now most of the highways we are covered. And next year also, we will be doing some 50 to 60 CNG stations minimum to ensure that anybody who is coming from Maharashtra, he goes up to Rajasthan or via Gujarat to Madhya Pradesh, he gets a CNG highway. Anybody in Gujarat traveling east to west or south to north, any direction, he will get uninterrupted CNG supply.
So have your commercial operations in Thane, have they begun?
We have got a connectivity done, and this weekend, I think I shared earlier, our first CNG station, mother station, and our first industry will be kicked off before 31st March this year.
All right, Mr. Patil, thank you very much for joining us here on Bloomberg Quinn. So that was the management of Gujarat Gas talking about the bidding strategy for the ninth auction.